Yeah. And Ed, one more, and that is the post-tribulation view, that basically the rapture is going to happen. Again, we've got it in the Bible. It's got to happen somewhere, okay? But they say, go you all the way through the tribulation, and you get right to the end, and just before you get there, or right at the end, something happens. Tell us what it is.
Yeah, in that view, the rapture takes place post, after the time of tribulation. So they view a time of tribulation coming, usually as 7 years. They view a rapture coming, but they put the rapture at the end of the time of tribulation, often saying things like, well, the church has always suffered persecution. Why would we expect to suffer persecution at the time of these judgments, etc.? But there's a huge difference between persecution and the divine wrath of God. The wrath of God is poured out in the book of Revelation. And what you're really saying is that the bride of Christ is going to suffer the wrath of Christ, who opens the seals, the wrath of God, who pours out the bowl judgments, and yet somehow the bride is going to survive until the very end. It's like beat up the bride and get her ready for eternity. To me, that's like Protestant purgatory. I think it's clear Jesus took the wrath for us on the cross. When he died in our place, the punishment against our sin was upon him on the cross. We deserve the wrath, but we won't receive the wrath because Jesus took the wrath of God for us.
You know, right in keeping with that, Ed, is 1 Thessalonians 4:18, which talks about, therefore encourage each other with these words. The post-trib view just doesn't fit with that. The church is going to go through the tribulation, through the seal judgments and the trumpet judgments and the bowl judgments and through Armageddon. Therefore, encourage each other with these words.
Yeah, I mean, I think of all these views, if you get to the midpoint of the tribulation, some scholars have calculated that you got 1 billion people that have died through the calamity. So peace and safety is not there at that spot. And we're going to talk about other verses in the Bible that actually talk about this and say Jesus is going to keep us from all of that. He's going to rescue us from all of that.